It's pretty typical for me to cry. Yeah. I'm a crier, so. But I can pull it back. When Sam was first born, he was diagnosed with microcephaly, and we had no idea until the pediatrician came into the room after Sam was about 5 hours old, and he said there's a concern for his head size because his head size is underdeveloped. You have your child, and it's, yay, it's a boy, and this is his name, and all these things as a mom and as a parent go through your mind, and all of a sudden you're going down this one path, and you kind of take a sharp turn in a different direction.
After he was born, I thought we spent more time at the hospital than we did, just at home sometimes. And it was just a lot of learning and trying to get familiar with the disability that he had. And it changed our paradigm of parenting quite a bit.
Rob finally said, God gave us our marriage and our life together. Gave us our son, and we're gonna live our life to the fullest. And I was so grateful that my husband did that for us, and that I was able to just grab onto and go, yes, you're so right. Sam's seizure started when he was 2 months old, and right now he has about 4 to 6 of the grand mals a month. There was a period of time where he was having 30 to 35 a month.
Toby sees our day-to-day here, and he knows we struggle with this and we struggle with that, and there's tension, there's all kinds of stuff that happens just with the pressures of life.
Sam's disability is a challenge because my parents can argue over it sometimes, and it's hard for them to, like, get him to bed, and we have to have someone who watches him at night, and for a long time we didn't have that, so one of my parents had to sleep out in the living room on the couch. So they didn't get a lot of sleep.
I call Sam my 24/7 guy. Yeah, he needs somebody who, I guess, kind of has him 24/7. Day-to-day care is getting him up, dressed. He does eat by G-tube, medications. We have a lot of sayings. It's our Trotter normal, so I guess it's normal care of Sam, and it's just become the way our family functions.
We got a little note from Joni in the mail. It says, sustain me according to your promise, and I will live. Do not let my hopes be dashed. And so that's something that we do pray for Sam at times.
When we first went to Joni and Friends, we had never been in a community of that many families who had been affected by disability. There was such celebration and joy in the midst of just our day-to-day stuff. And that was just, it was life-giving for me. I'm like, Lord, this is what I would love to have in my neighborhood. I am looking forward to sitting in my chair on the grass. Maybe I'm doing my Bible study, or maybe I'm just sitting there enjoying watching everybody just be who they are. It's like the neighborhood just hanging out and having a great time.
When you arrive at family camp, it's great because when you go across the bridge and everybody's there with their signs and they announce your name and everybody's cheering, and then you see your SDMs, you know, kind of following you to wherever you're parking or whatever, it's a great uplifting kind of arrival. They're awesome. I mean, the short-term missionaries, you can't put a price on the ministry that they do.
I'm working with the Trotter family, and my camper is Sam. He's very happy, and we spend a lot of time wheeling around the camp and just enjoying each other's company.
Me and my STM like to play basketball and just hang out around camp and just do a bunch of different things. Like yesterday we played Ultimate Frisbee, and we played a lot of basketball. A lot of basketball.
One of the big highlights for me at Family Retreat, and it usually is the Wednesday night date night, and that's just really fun. Rob and I get to go to dinner together with everybody else that we've gotten to know and reconnect with. One of my favorite things is we get to dance. We both love to dance. We may not necessarily be the best dancers, but we love to dance and just do that together. We do that once a year at Joni and Friends.
Part of the camp is that the dads go off site and we have a barbecue. And it was a good chance for you to get to kind of circulate around through all the dads. And that was a great time that God allowed us all as dads to have. Yeah!
So one of the ways that Sam really communicates to us about his relationship with God is through the way he worships the Lord. Sam's STM came up to me and she said, "Cheryl, look over, Sam is worshiping God." And I looked over at him and he was making movements that were outside of his typical pattern. And his face was full of joy, and I said, "Lord, he is worshiping you. If Sam is worshiping you, he knows you, you've given him spiritual gifts. You have got a calling on this boy's life to glorify his heavenly Father." Where is God in your life each day? That in the midst of any struggle, how is he really doing what he says he's gonna do? Because that's really what matters. It's where, like, your theology meets your reality. And Joni and Friends has helped me take God's word and put it into our family, however that looks.